Hello team, welcome back. And in this lecture, we will learn about the playbooks. We will see what are the Ansible playbooks and why we need to use the Ansible playbooks instead of the Ansible ad hoc commands. So let's start with. So till date, we are executing the things on Ansible and we was using the Ansible ad hoc commands. Basically, there are two ways to execute the task on Ansible client. One way we are already aware of using the ad hoc commands. And second way to execute the task on the Ansible client is the playbooks. So first we need to understand what is the difference between ad hoc commands and playbooks and why the playbook is a preferred way over the ad hoc commands. So why do we need the playbooks? Although we have the way to execute the things on the Ansible clients, why do we need the playbooks? So as long as your requirement to execute a single task, the ad hoc commands are good. Whenever you are going to execute a single command or you are going to perform a single task on Ansible client, the ad hoc command is a good option. But whenever you have a series of actions, right? Whenever you want to perform the multiple tasks on your server, what is the option in that case? In that case, ad hoc is not a good option because you need to execute the things multiple times and it will increase the chance of error. So what we will do, how we can execute a series of actions or a sequence of actions using the Ansible engine on Ansible clients? The option is playbook. With the help of playbook, you can execute the multiple configuration or multiple task or multiple actions in a one go on Ansible clients. Within the playbook, you can list out all the tasks, you can list out all the actions. And these actions can be directly performed on the Ansible client using a single execution. Playbook is basically a YAML format file. So you need to follow the YAML format. If you're not aware with the YAML file, you can go to Google and you can learn basic things about the YAML and YAML formatting. So whenever you are going to write the playbooks, you need to follow the YAML format. And within a single playbook, you can keep the multiple task. In the playbook, along with the task, user will also get option to use the dynamic things. What are those dynamic things which you can use? You can use the variables, you can use the files, you can use the templates. There are multiple things which you can use dynamically in the playbook. Once we will learn further, we will see what are those things which you can dynamically include in the playbook, which is not possible with the ad hoc commands. As I told you that playbooks are useful for the multiple things. Using the playbook, you can completely manage your configuration management. In a single go, you can execute the multiple configuration changes within your running infrastructure. If you want to deploy a fresh infrastructure, then definitely you can deploy the fresh infrastructure using the Ansible playbooks. And if you want to make an orchestration system, using which orchestration system you can deploy your complete infrastructure and you can manage the upgrade, you can manage the configuration management, then that thing is also possible with the Ansible playbook. Let's understand the structure of playbooks. What is the structure of playbooks? So playbook have the different component, and first is the concepts. Within the concepts, you have the task, then you have the play, then you have the playbooks. What are those things? What are the task, play and playbook? So play is something which is a combination of the task plus target. So whenever you want to perform the task, suppose you want to install some package, the package installation is a task. And on which particular target you want to install that package, that combination is called a play. So we have the combination of the task plus targets, that is called the play. What is a task? As I told you, task is something whenever you want to perform something on your Ansible client. So you can call it a single operation which user want to perform on the Ansible client, that is called the task. About the target, we are aware that target are the servers on which particular server we want to execute something, right? And you can define the specific target using the groups in Ansible inventory. Then what is the playbook? The combination of the multiple play or the list or sequence of the multiple plays are called the playbook. It means within a single playbook, you can have the multiple plays, and a single play is a combination of the task and the targets. Here on your screen, you are getting a sample playbook, and using this playbook, we want to execute something on my Ansible clients. So very first component is the name, right? This is an optional component. If you want to keep some name for your playbook, you can use this component. So you can define name colon the name of your playbook. The second is the host. This is nothing but this is the group name. In your inventory, whatever the group you want to use, you can use that group name in front of the host. What is this? What is become? So you remember whenever we was working with the AWS node, we was using the -b option in my ad hoc command whenever we want to execute something using the root user, because AWS node was executing by default using the EC2 user, right? And whenever we tried to install something on the AWS node, we was getting the error because EC2 user don't have the installation access on the nodes. So what we was doing, we was providing -b in my command. That option is used for -b. If you want to execute something from a specific user, you need to use the become option, right? And become must be yes. You also get an option that you can define the username by which particular user you want to execute that particular playbook. So we are defining the become and become underscore user. This become underscore user is default optional. If you are not defining this and you are just defining the become yes, then it will automatically switch to the root user. Then you are defining the task. Then we are defining the name of the task that we want to ensure that Apache is at the latest version. The name of task is again optional. If you want, you can define it. Otherwise, you can remove it. This is the module, right? This is the Ansible module. Please make sure YAML. Over here, we are defining the YAML. And as I told you earlier as well within the same course, this is a Ansible YAML module. This is not a OS native package manager. Correct. Then we are defining the name, which package I want to install, and defining the state. So this is the basic structure of your Ansible playbook, right? So over here you can see we are defining a single task. In the similar way, you can define multiple tasks over here and you can do the multiple operations, right? In the coming lecture, I will show you a demo that how you can execute the playbook on the Ansible engine and Ansible nodes. So thank you, team. That's all for the day.